Hi, welcome you guys to our big factory. What should I explain? Just go on with your questions.
Where are the three warehouses?
Where are the warehouses? Oh, this is the central warehouse. Okay, so see the storage technology. Everything comes on this belt, is then removed and put in different lanes here. This is two boxes parallel, four boxes, one. So we have different setups that we can decide how many places for how many boxes we want to use for a material. And in this four are stones, and you see there are 50 stones in one box. And these boxes are steel boxes. Steel box is the expensive box we can have. And you see we have here stones, steel, iron, there's a bricks that is to fill up the sea ground, iron, copper, rocket fuel, coal, sulfate, fuel for the atomic plants. And yeah, the warehouse becomes fuller and fuller, and we want to have an idea to remove perhaps the stones. Other questions? Perhaps I should have you explain where we need the stones.
Yes, which reason got the bricks and the stones?
Okay. The basic of rocket science is research. These are our research facilities. Okay. And if you have the right mixture, you can do research. For example, we can now research here, what is it? Oh, it's in German, sorry. Raffinierte entzündliche Stoffe, six different colors yep. we can produce. And one of them, I can show it here, one of them needs tracks, and tracks need stones, steel, and iron. And there's another one. It needs here the walls, and walls need bricks, and bricks are also made from stone. This is here a small Kanban system. They consume the science packages. The science packages are produced here. So if you want to produce here the blue one, I have to produce also tracks. Here I have two places to produce tracks. Here is the production of walls. The walls need bricks, and bricks need stone. And so I have to bring in heat at this place stones.
So you need the stones to produce bricks into your
bricks,
science facility.
Bricks to walls, and walls are also for the science packages here.
Okay.
For what was it here? For this military science.
So those stones are mandatory for your facility.
Okay. So we need it here, and we need it for the tracks. Okay. We have stones here. We have also a furnace here, produce much pollution. We need also a facility to produce the walls. And we need two machines to produce tracks. We bring it only stones in for these two products. And even the stones are already in our warehouse, because we need stones also at other places. So we have also stones in our warehouse. And then we have the bricks in the warehouse. Then we have stones in the warehouse, bring them to the research facility, produce new stones to make walls. Wouldn't it be easier to bring tracks here and stones here? There's everything in the warehouse. Only tracks not. And 100 tracks fit in one place in a box. And then it's a matter of calculation. If we fill 32 places with tracks, how much material is consumed? All the places are free. So we get free space in our warehouse. That takes some time for production, and we have to organize it. My worker here, okay, you can say, hey, if I do everything by hand, to empty all the boxes here would be very, very slow, right?
Yes.
The question is, if I remove the stones here, I will create three places. Three places, the stones are away, a little bit of the steel, of the iron, and I put the tracks to other place. And there's no need to store stones for the bricks, because bricks are already in the warehouse, because we need them also for other buildings. There's another place where we have many, many stones.
So you're trying to reduce your space in the warehouses?
Yes.
With the creation of the tracks?
With the creation of tracks, this is higher value. Okay, they're a little bit more expensive, but 100 tracks need only one place in a box. And the material for the 100 tracks is two places stones, one place iron, one place steel. We reduce the space in the warehouse and we can put other things in. So you can place an order and say, give me stones and steel and iron and bring it somewhere, produce your tracks and bring them back to the warehouse. But everything is used here. Here I have an area for extensions. You don't have to build it and program it. You want to have a calculation, what is the best plan? Is it a good idea to remove the stones? It's not a good idea because then we have to produce the tracks. Now we can produce it locally here close to the warehouse because there's everything. But if all stones are away, we have no stones anymore here, and then we have to find out where we can produce more tracks for later use.
How much stone are you producing per day?
We never calculated the throughput per day or per hour or so on, because the factory is pull oriented. So I send signals and produce whatever I need. This is the burning area. Here we can produce more copper plates. Here's copper ore. We can produce also more iron plates. There's iron ore. We can produce bricks from stones. Here's a local warehouse of stones, and we can produce steel from iron plates. This can be automated. That is not very difficult to produce bricks here. And perhaps it would be also a good place to produce tracks, that we can have tracks as many as we want. The basic question is it a good idea to remove the stones, replace with tracks, produce tracks at the other place, and bring then the tracks and the stones we already have to our research facilities? We think it is cheaper. Everything is known. And then we have other situation. If you have the data, you can calculate everything with Excel, because the distance are clear, the layout is clear, all timings and material requirements are known. That's it.
Very often you create your factory and you said, I will have the best boxes, best technology, best rocket science, whatever you want. And later you find it was not very intelligent to put all the stones in our expensive warehouse. That is logistic optimization.